Okay, I already start my recording. So today we are going to learn Max Chapter 3 Logical Reasoning. Hopefully you are all energetic. Jangan tidur. Hopefully I will do my best. Okay. So for Chapter 3, sebelum ini we already learned not susah. It's easy. Monster energy. Okay, it's easy, but you need to know the terms to get your marks. If no, you don't have any terms, then susah lah. Okay, so before this, you already learned about inductive, deductive, and then the inverse, converse. Semua sudah learn lah. Before this, I already terangkan. If no, I can tunjuk this thing lah. Oh, I'm using night mode lah. Sekejap. Tukar mode. Okay. Switch background. So, yang ni lah kita sudah belajar sebelum ni. Yang I ask. Implication, converse, inverse, control, positive. Kalau terbalik apa. If you negate, jadi apa. This one you already learn before this. Saya sudah ajar. Kepada yang new to this. Boleh tengok recording lah sebelum ni. Saya sudah terangkan cara nak hafal secara mudah. Tak perlu risau untuk terms-terms tu. So, today we are going to learn about forms. Kita ada beberapa form yang kita perlu tahu for deductive. Okay, I want to ask before we start this one. Deductive is general to specific or specific to general? Deductive. Going to ask about deductive. General to specific.
General to specific.
Yes, correct. General to specific. G to S. Because depth. Yeah, correct. Still remember. Depth. Awak ingat lah depth. So depth means ada S, right? So D for deductive. Yes, correct. General to specific. D. S. Okay, Dex. Okay, I want to ask before starting. You want me to switch background to black or white? Which one do you prefer? Saya ikut majority vote. You want black or white?
White.
Okay, Aaron said white. So, if you take black and then can white. Okay, two of you white, one black. And then, lagi.
White.
3 white, 1 black. Okay lah, jadi I masuk white je lah. Okay, never mind lah. Masuk white je. Never mind. So for white, kita tengok. That's. So kita dalam chapter 3, penakulan logic or logical reasoning, kita akan tengok bentuk. Kita panggil bentuk in BM or in English is form. Not form 1 untuk tingkatan 1, bukan tu. This one is bentuk. They call form. So form, we have 3 kind of form. Kita ada 3 bentuk. Form 1, form 2 and form 3. Bentuk 1, bentuk 2, bentuk 3. So awak tengok, kita ada 3 bentuk and then cuba tengok sikit. Mereka guna terms premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion. Dalam BM pun sama. Premise 1, premise 2 and kesimpulan. Ini terms untuk BM. So awak kena tahu, jangan takut lepas tengok premise. Ha, jangan ingat it's a shop lot, not that or other things. It's premise maksudnya, kat sini it's ayat. First ayat and then the second ayat, baru kesimpulan. Mereka akan simpulkan, conclude with that, the first premise and then the second premise. So kat sini kita boleh tengok, kita ada 3 bentuk. We have 3 form, 3 kind of form. So the first one is all A are B. Kat sini, why they use A, B and C or P or Q? Yang tu semua ialah satu, term. Mereka akan guna ayat. Mereka boleh masukkan apa-apa sahaja. But the black color is wajib. Yang black color tu wajib. Tapi yang A, B, C tu, mereka boleh tukar apa sahaja. It's their wish. They can use anything. It could be, you can see the first one kat sini. All Ni sama kan, all A, A, B, A. Awak boleh tengok kat sini A, ada kan A. But actress and good at dancing tu A and B lah, macam tu. So mereka akan guna apa-apa sahaja, but we need to know that all and R is the form. Macam tu juga this one. If then is true, is true, is true, is not true lah. Okay. So kat sini awak boleh tengok the black one. Awak tengok, awak dapat benda tu, baru yang tu boleh dijadikan sebagai the form. Baru awak boleh categorize. If not, you cannot categorize that. So, yang ni kita tengok the first form first. First form first. Okay, kita tengok the pertama one lah. Bentuk first. So, yang ni all A R B. And then the premise tu, they say C is A. Okay, C maksudnya bukan A, bukan B. Yang tu, it could be another term. C is A. Semua A ialah B. Lepas tu C ialah A. C ialah B. Macam tu. Okay. So kat sini, kita ada premise tu and conclusion. Awak tengok C, C. Awak kena ingat the format. Sebab kita akan guna format itu untuk nantilah kita akan ada soalan. So, what you need to do, you need to memorize the form. Like the first form, how is it? And then the second form, what's the difference between form 1 and form 2? You can see that it's clear that the form 1, they use all. And then the second form, they use if, then. So kat sini awak boleh tengok ada dua perkara yang berbeza. And then you see the form 3. Form 3, they use if, then also. But what the additional thing there is not. Bukan. So mereka guna bukan or not. That's the additional thing. So awak kena tahu macam mana nak bezakan. And then another thing, kat sini kita tengok the second form. Second form, if P then Q. Awak tengok the pink color highlight and the orange color one. If P then Q, P is true, Q is true. Mereka start dari P and then baru Q. But for form 3, awak tengok. If P then Q, still same. And then the premise 2, they say not Q is true. So the orange color is first, not the pink color. Okay, so that's the difference. Jangan terkeliru. Not Q is true, not P is true. So they start with Q, then yang ni awak boleh tengok. So itu pun antara perbandingan that you need to know. The differentiate, how you differentiate between this. So yang ni specifically for deductive statements, deductive arguments. Why deductive only? Kenapa deductive sahaja? Sebab kita tahu deductive is general to specific, umum ke khusus. So yang ni kita akan khususkan. Maksudnya the premise 1 would be general, akan jadi umum. Nanti premise 2 and conclusion would be khusus, specific. So awak boleh tengok C is A, C is B. C would be akan jadi specific things lah C tu. Macam tu juga untuk the second form and third form. Awak boleh tengok mereka justifikasikan, justify the P statement and then the Q one. So P is true, Q is true, or not P is true, not Q is true. So yang tu awak boleh tengok mereka specify that. So general to specific. Now we tengok dulu. Okay, look at this. We have premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion. For this, premise 1, all actresses are good at dancing. So if you see all are, you can memorize it as all A are B, C is A, C is B. Okay, so awak tengok ini pun terus boleh dah dapat tu. And then you can see that all actresses are good at dancing. So awak tengok kat sini ada Jasmine. So Jasmine is C kat situ. Jasmine ialah C. is Jasmine is an actress. So awak tengok actress, actress tu kat mana? Kat first ke kat second? So kat first maksudnya A lah. Ha, so mereka ikut the first premise macam the second premise lah. Ha, mereka ikut the form 1 statement. And then awak tengok Jasmine is good at dancing. Good at dancing kan kat belakang. So still same. Maksudnya they fulfill the statement. Mereka gunakan form 1. Mereka guna bentuk pertama. They didn't use bentuk 2 or bentuk 3. Why I am saying this, awak kena tahu nanti akan ada soalan yang kita perlu tentukan betul ke tak betul. Okay. So, for this, is it clear? Boleh faham? Okay, Kishan said yes. Biharan. Okay, yang lain. Lia, Emily, Fazliana, Nitish, Kenna. Everyone? Tidur. Not tidur, ha? Okay, jangan tidur. Tersambung. Now, this is the, like, most famous questions in paper 1 or even paper 2. Famous sangat. So, paper 1, apa yang mereka boleh tanya and paper 2, mereka boleh tanya macam ni. Are the following arguments valid and sound? So awak tengok sekarang another statement, another term, not statement, another term, valid and sound. So mereka tanya argument berikut sah ataupun munasabah. Saya dah tulis DM siap-siap. Sah ataupun munasabah, valid and sound. If it's not, justify your answer. So, kalau awak kata tidak sah or tidak munasabah, awak kena nyatakan sebab. You need to justify your answer. If not, you will not get your marks. So, awak kena tahu. Kita tengok A. All multiple of 16 are even numbers. So, awak tengok the first premise, awak boleh anggarkan. It would be form 1 or form 2 or form 3. Form berapa? Which form? All. They use all. One. Kishan, not two. Awak tengok kat sini. Form 1, form 2, form 3. All A are B. Untuk form 1 sahaja. Bentuk 1 sahaja. Bentuk 2 and bentuk 3 mereka guna if P then Q. If P then Q. Mereka guna jika maka. Tapi bentuk 1 sahaja mereka guna all. So awak kena tahu. I do this B1, B2, B3. What does it mean? B1, B2, B3. Bentuk 1, bentuk 2, bentuk 3. Ataupun you can also write as F1, F2 and F3. So awak tengok kat sini. Saya tulis kat sini lah. Okay. Ni all. Mereka guna all. Untuk bentuk 1 mereka guna all for premise 1. Premise 2 mereka khususkan C is A then C is B. Yang ni untuk conclusion. Okay. And then awak tengok untuk the bentuk 2, they use if P then Q. Kat sini berbeza. And bentuk 3 pun mereka guna if P then Q. So awak tengok sama kan. Apa yang beza kat sini, bentuk 2 mereka positif. Tapi bentuk 3 mereka negatif kan. Negatif sexist lah. Sorry, kena buat muka sikit. Okay, baru boleh nampak. If P then Q. Macam mana if P then Q? Kena, saya tunjuk. Naik atas pula. P is true, Q is true. Macam tu. P is true, Q is true. But for the bentuk 3, awak tengok. Mereka kata not Q is true, not P is true, not Q is true, not P is true. So awak tengok, mereka kata not true, not true. So it's negative statement. So awak boleh ingat B1 semua, B2 happy, B3 sad. Can understand. Bezakan. Boleh. Kena not okay, kan? Okay, we respond. Saya takut semua tidur. Huh? Okay, thanks. So the first one. All multiples of 16 are even numbers. Kita sekarang ni, kita belum tahu tau. Kita belum tahu yang tu dia menepati bentuk satu ataupun tidak. Like completely form one or not. We don't know about that. So what? Okay. Oops. Going to rain, I think. Okay. Kita tak tahu. Bentuk satu, mereka like the premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion, dia daripada form 1 or not, kita tak tahu. Tapi apa yang kita boleh teka by the first premise, itu yang tempat kita teka. Bentuk 1 ke 2 or 3. So by the first question, we know that all are ialah bentuk 1. Kita tulis dulu bentuk 1. Kita tak tahu lagi dia full bentuk 1 ke tak. And then the premise 2, tengok 64 is a multiple of 16. Mereka guna yang depan dulu, baru mereka guna yang belakang. Even number kat belakang. So, awak tengok. Kita boleh tahu mereka all A is B, C is A, C is B. So, kalau ikut format 1, format 1, form 1. So, mereka start dari A and then baru ke B. So, yang ni betul. Form 1. Yes, Kishan. Kishan? Oh, okay. No. So, yang ni dia memang bentuk satu. Kita boleh, we can conclude that. That's form 1. So, kat sini mereka kata, are the following arguments valid and sound? Justify your answers. So, untuk validity and sound, macam mana kita nak tahu, kita tengok statement ini, okay? The validity, okay, sah, ke penentuan, penentuan sah, okay. Yang tu, validity of an argument is determined based on the forms of argument. So it's based on forms, not about the conclusion, not about the rest. It's about form only. Okay, only. And then not based on the truth of the premises or the conclusion. So maksudnya dia tak kait dengan apa-apalah yang lain. Hanya bentuk sahaja. So kita boleh tengok, saya sudah buat juga. Valid sah ikut bentuk. Okay, ikut bentuk form. Okay. Second one, sound. Sound, awak ingat bunyi kan? It's about bunyi. If we translate bulat-bulat lah. But in the end is munasabah. So munasabah ke tidak munasabah, yang tu kita ikut conclusion or kesimpulan. We will follow that. Okay, conclusion or kesimpulan. So by the first question, we already know that yang tu valid or not. Valid or not valid. Valid, right? Kenapa valid? Valid. Kenapa valid? Sebab it's because form 1 lah. That's why. Because it's form 1. Kita boleh tentukan form mana. Matches form 1, yeah. So it's valid. Now you want to know that it's there you wrote in Malay for valid and sound. Can you explain them in English? Which one? Yeah. There you wrote in Malay. Oh, okay. Okay. For valid, you need to follow the form. Like, you can know that that statement, that the premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion is applying to which form. You boleh samakan if it's valid. If it's sleep, it means that ada masalah dalam premise 2 or conclusion or even premise 1. It could be, okay, saya bagi contoh untuk not valid, okay, not valid, saya bagi contoh. All multiples of 16 are even numbers, okay. Yang tu betul. The premise 2, mereka mungkin bagi 64 is an even numbers. And then the conclusion, 64 is multiple of 16. So awak tengok, is it complying to the any of the form? Walaupun kita tengok the first premise is right, premise 2 and conclusion is wrong. Kenapa? Kita tahu C is A, baru C is B. Tapi apa yang saya buat tadi, saya terbalikkan. So kalau terbalikkan, automatically it would be wrong. That's why kita akan kata it's not valid. Jangan guna invalid. Okay, so understand, but for sound, okay, sound, it's about the conclusion. Kita kena tahu the conclusion is correct or not. You see the first one, 64 is an even number. Is it right? Even or not even? It's even number or odd number? True, right? So kalau benar, maksudnya it's sound. Yeah, even. So dia sound lah. Boleh faham? Sound. Okay. Now you can understand. Yang ni senang saja. Okay? So, valid kita kata untuk form. Kalau beza sikit pun sudah salah tau. Jangan anggap, oh mereka buat salah, we can do anything. No. Kalau sedikit beza pun salah. Automatically. Tiada kesian kat situ. Automatic, you can say it's not valid. Okay. If you use invalid in your exam, I don't know. Sebab saya takut nanti tak ada dalam skema, because in your textbook, they use not valid. They didn't use invalid. And they use not sound. Mana not sound tadi? Not sound. Yes, which mana? There is valid. Okay, there is valid. Mute instead of not sound. You can use not valid. Wait, like this. Valid. Can. Not valid. Can. Don't use. Don't use invalid. Okay. For sound, not sound. Sound. Ayah, tak nampak. Not sound. So, ini betul, ini pun betul. Apa yang salah, jangan guna mute. Macam, tadi siapa kata? Haran kata. Don't use that. So, yang ni perkara yang you need to elakkan. Don't use invalid, don't use mute. Why I'm telling this? Because in your textbook, they use not valid and not sound. So, we use that. Sometimes, if in your answer scheme, they didn't include invalid and mute. Sometimes, mereka boleh kata like this. If invalid can accept. Macam tu, mereka boleh bagi macam ni kat dalam skema. Tapi we don't know if the skema for that year, they didn't write that invalid. So apa yang you nak buat? Even though it's correct, then awak akan salah. Sebab apa? Sebab dalam skema, they use not valid. They didn't use invalid. Sebab tu saya kata, sampai deep macam ni, why you need to follow your textbook? Sebab mereka tidak boleh mempertikaikan. Yes, that's the word. Tidak boleh mempertikaikan because it's in your textbook. So, we follow what's in our textbook. Okay? Tapi kalau awak kata not sound, not valid, you need to give the reason also. Sebab soalan tu mereka kata justify, right? So you need to justify. Kita tengok the second one. Kita tengok second one. Premise 1. All basketballs are in the spherical shape. So awak tengok. All. Yang ni kalau awak tengok sekali pandang first premise it would be which form? Huh? Form 1 or form 2, form 3? Form 1, yeah. Would be form 1. Okay. Lepas tu awak tengok premise 2. The earth is in spherical shape. The earth is C. Is should be A. Maksudnya yang ni A kan, yang ni B. Should be A. Tapi kat situ B kan. Sudah jadi B. So, sudah salah. Boleh faham? It's not valid. Does not comply with a valid form of deductive argument. Okay? So, yang ni not valid. Why? It's not form 1. Walaupun premise 1 nampak macam bentuk 1, tapi the premise 2 is not form 1. Okay? Sebab tu sudah salah and it's not valid. And now, you tengok dulu. Is munasabah or not sound ke not sound? The earth is a basketball. True or false? Kishan said false. Haran said false. Okay, so memang false lah. Okay, not sound. Because the conclusion is false. Earth is not basketball. Okay, jangan anggap basketball. Because it won't bounce. Yeah. Yes, it won't bounce. Betul. Okay, the C. Question C. If W less than 9, then W less than 19. So now, bentuk 1 ke 2 ke 3? Which form? Awak boleh bagi antara 2 lah, if you don't know. Okay. Kishan said 3. So yang lain? Haran? Because negative. Oh, Kishan say even negative. Emily, Fazliana, Nitish, Haran. Jawab. Because negative, right? You ask me, right? You are asking me, okay. So, here, this one is not a negative statement. It's not a negative. Kalau mereka jadikan negative, maksudnya mereka guna macam ni. It should be macam ni. Terbalik dengan ni. Okay, boleh faham? Or they use not for baru is negative. But now it's still in a positive form. So it's yes, Haran. Base pula. Bentuk dua. Form two. So tengok. Ni and then this. They guna. Yang ni. 4 kurang daripada 9. 4 kurang daripada 19. Okay. Kita tengok bentuk 2. Apa kita punya ni? P is true, Q is true. Not Q is true, not P is true. Itu antara pilihan kita kan? Antara nak tentukan yang mana. So, kat sini kita tengok mereka guna 4 kurang daripada 9. True ke? 4 kurang daripada 9? Is it true? 4 less than 9? False? True? True. Don't false. So yang first one is true. Okay, kita kena dapatkan conclusion pun true, baru dia jadi valid. Okay, so 4 less than 19? This report. Okay. It's also true. So our tengok. Second one, the second premise and then the conclusion is true. So, it means that it complies to form 2. Okay. So, maksudnya yang ni valid. Okay. Sekarang kita kena tentukan. Is it sound or not? Not sound. So, sound ke? Sound tengok apa? Kalau sound? What do you need to check for sound? Conclusion, yeah. So conclusion, is it true?
True.
So if true, It sound lah. Tally and sound. Okay.
Yeah.
Yes, Kishan. Alright. Okay. Yang lain, Fazli Ana. Okay. Fazli Ana and Emily. Niti semua masih ada ke? Reply juga. Okay. So, D. Premise 1. If A less than 0, then AX power of N is a quadratic expression. A less than 0, AX power of N plus BX plus C is a quadratic expression. So, kita tengok dulu. Kita guna if then. So, it could be form 2 or form 3. Now, awak tengok. A tidak sama dengan kosong. Is it true? Is it true? Yes, true. Yang ni true. Awak tengok the second one. Kalau true, baru jadi betul. Baru jadi valid. If tak true, maksudnya tak jadi valid. Okay, you see that. Conclusion, is it true? Kishan said yes. Harun said? Harun? True. Okay. Kat sini, conclusion is false. Not true. Boleh tengok tak? Ada masalah kat sini. Apa yang masalah? Yes, we have a thing here. We have a mistake. What's that? Siapa boleh tentukan apa yang salah kat situ? Power should be 2 for quadratic. Yes, correct. So, yang tu, yang kuasa 2, power of 2 is a compulsory thing for quadratic expression. Yeah. Kena jadi kuasa 2. So, AXN plus BX plus C. Kalau N tu jadi 3, is it quadratic expression? If jadi 3? No, false. So, kalau mereka bagi N, maksudnya, apa-apalah, it could be any, yes, always 2, yes. It should be 2. It could be any pemalak. Apa-apa pun, awak tak boleh anggapkan sebagai 2. Sebab, it could be any number. So, yang ni kena jadi 2. Yang ni A, ni B, ni C. Yang tu boleh berubah-ubah. Itu tiada masalah. Okay. So, power of 2 is a compulsory thing that. Sebab ada kuasa 2, baru dia jadi quadratic. Okay. So, yang tu false. So, is it valid? Is it valid? Valid or not valid? Not valid. Okay, correct. Not valid. So, sound or not sound? Sound or not sound? Not sound. Yeah, correct. Not sound sebab conclusion is false. Habis. Macam tu je awak kata. Why I cannot write? What happened? Okay. Conclusion. Oh my god. Is false. Habis. Awak tulis macam tu je. Not some. Don't use method. Conclusion is false. Okay. Habis. Kita tengok E. Sekarang buat sendiri. Bentuk apa? Form berapa? Form berapa? Boleh jadi form apa? K3. So, tengok. it does comply to, does it comply to form 3? Semua, premise 1, 2 and 3, not 3, we don't have premise 3, we have conclusion. So conclusion, semua menepati ke bentuk 3, form 3, check, check, buat sendiri the E1. If menepati, you can write valid. If not, you need to write not valid. Saya nak tanya, nak tengok jawapan awak. Okay. Type your answer. If I'm right, it's not valid. Okay, Kishan said not valid. So? Hey, conclusion is not true. Not, so not even any form. Not valid.
Yeah.
Correct. Betul. Kishan and Haran. Yang tu not valid. Why not valid? It does not comply to any form. Kalau do premise 2, awak tengok 12 is not divisible by 8. It should be 4 dulu, baru jadi 8. So, sudah salah. Okay? So, not valid. So, 12 is not divisible by 4. Betul ke? False or true? Huh? False, right? So, not sound. Habis. Not valid, not sound. Macam tu juga untuk F. Kita tengok latihan sikit. Soalan pertama, 3.2b. Cuba tengok. Are the following arguments valid and sound? If it's not, justify your answer. Premise 1. All multiples of 5 are multiples of 10. 35 is a multiple of 5. 35 is a multiple of 10. Form 1. Okay, yes, it should be form 1. And is it valid? Semua premise betul ke? The premise true and conclusion, is it same as the form 1? Okay, so what's your answer? How do you write? Macam mana nak tulis? Bagi jawapan yang pendek dulu, yang sebab tak apa. Bagi yang the answer first. Okay, Haran said valid. Then? And not sound. Okay, Haran said valid and not sound. Yang lain agree ke? Everyone here, do you agree? Confusion, thumbs up. Okay, so betul. Okay, the first one betul. Valid and not sound. So, kalau awak kata not, apa-apa awak kata not valid or not sound, you need to give the reason. So, if you say not sound, why is you say not sound? Because conclusion. Is false. Kalau conclusion false, of course premise 1 pun false lah. Why premise 1 false? All multiple of 5. Yang ni 35 is multiple of 5 what? So yang tu betul. Are multiples of 10. So yang tu bukanlah. Maksudnya yang ni conclusion and premise 1 is not is lah. Are false. Okay? So, conclusion and premise 1 are false. Dari situ, awak boleh bagi jawapan. So, the second one. All squares have right angle. PQRS is a square. PQRS has right angles. Okay. Current.
Yeah.
Yeah. It should be winner. But, oops. Pendulum. Oh, you got it from the textbook. Okay. Oh. Errata correction book. Oh. You got errata. Wow. So it's not your textbook, la. It's errata. Wow. So they changed the term. Oh my god. Okay. Which? So, Haran, thank you for that. So, according to errata mathematics form 5, if it's sound. So, yang valid still same. Valid kalau form. The premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion still like complies to the form. Maksudnya betul. Okay. So, kalau sound maksudnya first kena valid dulu. So, awak boleh teruslah jadi macam ni. Kalau awak kata, sorry, if awak, oh my god, why cannot it is, okay. So, kalau awak kata is not valid, terus awak boleh kata not sound. Sebab kalau sound, first kena valid, baru awak kena tengok the second one is the premise. Okay. Premise and okay. Premise and the conclusions. Okay. Are true or not? Okay, kena true lah. Okay. I got both. I got put. Oh, inside the textbook they put. Oh. No, I didn't get it. So they, oh, maybe my batch, they received it from their teacher. Could be. I think I didn't receive it. Oh, I also don't know what happened. But like mostly, kalau awak tengok satu pun sudah cukup lah. You ingat satu je. Like just now, for my SPM, I followed that also. Valid sound kan? So valid awak tengok form. Dia ikut form, the bentuk is every each of it. Premise 1, premise 2 and conclusion. Is it same or not? It has like different and then it would be not valid. Sebab awak akan tengok lagi, akan ada another term. Sebab tu you akan confused. That's why I'm not giving sangat like panjang-panjang penerangan. Awak tengok ni, awak akan tengok lagi strong or weak, and then cogent or not cogent. Itu pun ada lagi. So apa yang saya nak beritahu, we just memorize one term for each of it. Kalau awak tengok valid, awak terus kena ingat form, bentuk mana, betul ke tak. Kalau awak tengok sound or not sound, awak kena tengok conclusion. Habis. Kalau conclusion pun sudah salah, of course the premise 1 pun sudah salah lah. Because premise 1 general, then baru jadi specific. So the specific one is wrong, terus the general thing also wrong. Macam tu. So kita ingat satu je supaya tak confuse. Okay, can lah Haran. But a good thing you show me the errata. Bagus. Sebab saya pun kena tahu kan. So kita still ingat yang ni. But I ingat lah, my teacher, my sir said, dalam textbook ini, waktu mereka buat ada banyak masalah. And then ada keluar another, like the errata lah, ada keluar buku tu. And then, maybe, I don't know, like, kelas saya tak dapat. I also don't know. Little bit tebal, right? So, still, mereka tak boleh, like, blame on you. Why? Because in your textbook still same what? Kalau mereka nak blame you, they should change the book. Maksudnya, mereka tak boleh keluarkan errata macam tu. Mereka kena tukar buku tu semua, baru boleh blame on you. Kalau dalam SPM tu salah lah. Tapi kat sini, mereka sudah keluarkan buku and then it's just an additional errata. mungkin ada cikgu yang tengok, mungkin ada cikgu yang tak tengok. So saya rasa my sir, bukan cikgu lah, sir. So sir tu rasanya dia tak tengok lah. Dia just biarkan. So it depends on your teachers and sirs also. Tapi tebal kan, like saya ingat lah my sir said ada banyak masalah dalam buku teks matematik. So betul lah, saya rata. Okay, so kita still ikut ni lah. Okay, kalau you nak ingat yang ni pun sama, it just same tapi sikit je beza. Kita include premise, kalau awak tak nak ikut premise pun boleh, tiada masalah. Okay, so the second one, all squares have right angles, PQRS is a square, PQR has right angles. Okay, kat sini cuba tengok. Betul ke? Is it valid or not valid? Okay. Not have word, so totally not valid. Not have word. What word? Haran. Which word? All squares have right angle. PQRS is a square. PQR has. Why? Because dia salah. Which one? Awak kata kena ini ke? This one should be R. Haran. You mean it like this? Form 1 got R right now, premise 1. No. Oh, premise 1 R. All A are B. Oh, now here they said what they do. What did they say? Dalam errata mereka tukar ke? Now kita kena rujuk R. All squares have right angles. Yang tu still boleh dianggap betul. Sebab tiada masalah. Apa yang selalu jadi masalah kat situ, when yang ni dengan ini mereka terbalikkan. Itu yang kesalahan major. So like the minor mistakes tak ada lah. Nanti awak tengok errata tu lah. Maybe they give, I also don't know. Mereka mungkin tukar 3.2b, the second question, mereka tambah R lagi. Tapi yang ni selalunya, because it's not a major mistake, they didn't tukar. Tapi yang ni sebab dia tak major, still is valid. Because yang ni, first dia ikut yang ni kan, all A is B. So mereka ikut A dulu, baru B. So C is B. Okay. So yang ni, yang ni still valid. Okay? Awak boleh anggap lah. Tapi selalunya apa yang like a major mistake, mereka tukar yang tu, itu jadi mistake besar. Tak boleh jadi valid. Okay? So it's still valid. And then it sound or not, PQRS has right angles. PQRS is a square. So it has right angles or not? Haran. Vision. Yeah, conclusion is correct. So, because conclusion correct lah. So, kat sini pun kita boleh ambil lah. Conclusion betul, maksudnya premise satu pun betul. So, conclusion should be correct. Okay? Vision, conclusion, correct. Okay, betul. Semua betul. So, kita kata sound. If this one is square root x less than 3, then x less than 9, set 4 less than 3, 4 less than 9. Awak tengok, is it valid or not valid? Conclusion, Under one question, we have to say it's a sound or just put there sound. Itu tak ada masalah. Awak tulis sound ke, it's a sound pun boleh, mana-mana. Semua boleh betul. Ha. Tapi jangan tulis yang muted or like invalid. Ha. Okay, yes. Ha. Kena clarify supaya awak tak ha, ni. Ha, silent. Ha. Jangan tambah-tambah, okay? Nanti semua keliru. Okay, so yang ni, is it valid? Valid tak? Cert 4, less than 3 ah. Is it true? Cert 4, less than 3, is it true? False. Cert 4, awak dapat berapa? Kishan? 2, right? 2 darat 2 berapa? 4 kan? Okay, so macam tu lah. Cert maksudnya, like you can divide. Macam 2 darat 2 jadi 4 kan? Macam tu lah. So it's true. So 2 is less than 3. Yang ni true. Yang ni 4 less than 3. True juga. So it's valid. Habis. Now, is sound or not 4 less than 9? True kan? So true lah. So sound. Habis. Done. Okay. Fourth question. Setiap kali you buat soalan akan kadang-kadang you boleh jumpa yang berbeza-beza. So the fourth one. If k minus 5 less than 9, then k is greater than 9. 10 minus 5 less than 9, 10 is greater than 9. Okay, now 10 minus 5, 5 is less than 9, 10 is greater than 9. Okay, now, is it valid or not valid? If k minus 5 less than 9, then k greater than 9. Lepas tu mereka bagi nilai 10 tolak 5, 5 kurang daripada 9, true. 10 greater than 9, true. So yang ni dia valid, yes, correct. Question, valid. Now sound or not sound? Kishan said sound. Okay, wait. Spell it. Okay. K minus 5, 9. Okay, lah. 10 is greater than 9. Betul. Sound. Okay, wait, if the premise 2 and conclude not true, straight away not very right now. Yeah, correct. Wait, no. You cannot like predict that. Premise 2 and conclusion not true, boleh jadi bentuk 3, form 3. Tapi awak kena tengok, they start with Q or not. Kalau start dari Q, if like apa, yang atas tu, jap saya tunjuk. I will show you. If Q is true, not Q is true, not P is true. Kena ikut tu, baru boleh jadi negatif. Mereka start dari Q, baru P. Kalau false boleh, sebab not true, right? Boleh jadi false kat situ. Boleh faham? Okay. So, can tuan-tuan. Mana soalan kita tadi? Okay, if k minus 5 less than 9. Okay, boleh ke macam ni? Kita jadikan k sebagai 2. Sekejap. If 2 tolak 5 less than 9. K tu boleh jadi apa-apa nombor kan kat sini. So kalau kita jadikan 2 tolak 5 is negative 3 less than 9. Okay, yang ni true. Then K is 2 greater than 9. Is it true? Kat sini false. So kena tengok jugalah premise 1. Yang ni false. So yang ni false. Sebab 2 is not greater than 9, right? So maksudnya kat sini it's valid tapi not sound sebab premise 1 is false. Sekarang another thing here. Okay, baru saya pun jumpa. Selalu saya tengok conclusion. Tapi kat sini conclusion is right. Tapi sebab K. Okay, nasib baik Haran send me your errata. Baru boleh jumpa. Okay, so K greater than 9. So kat sini K boleh jadi apa-apa juga. Tak mungkin dia jadi 10 sahaja. Because they didn't like nyatakan like it's an even number or it's a real number. Apa-apa mereka tak kata. It's just K. So it could be any number that. So kalau awak substitute in another number, kat situ sudah salah. So it's not sound lah because the premise one is false. Boleh tak? Can understand. Okay, Haran. Okay, Haran said okay. Kishan? Haran said okay. Kishan said understand. Okay, now. Third, the fifth one. Premise one, if X is a factor of 6, then could be anything, yeah. This could be anything. If X is a factor of 6, then X is divisible by X. Wow, then 6 is divisible, okay? 6 is divisible by 3. 3 is a factor of 6. Okay, is it valid? Is it valid? Valid ke tak ada valid? Not valid lah. Kishan, yeah, correct. Haran, boleh dapat ke? Is it valid? It's not valid lah. Not valid. Kenapa saya kata not valid? Because yang ni tengok, dia start dari 6. Should. Yang ni dia jadi 3. Divisible by 3. Yang ni mereka start dari belakang, baru start pergi depan. Itu sudah jadi salah lah. Okay, so it's not valid. Lepas tu Sound or not sound? Cuba tengok. Not in order.
Yeah,
sound or not sound? Oh, just now Bala Subramaniam answered. Okay, listen. Said not in order, not sound. Saying sound or not sound? Sound, na? Saying sound. Why sound? Haran, Kishan, why sound? Kenapa sound? Sekarang kita tambah lagi conclusion and premise 1. Conclusion and premise 1 is Turu. Yeah, correct. All premises and conclusion is true. Bala Subramaniam, why am I? What happened? Oh! I thought another person. My message is just showing your, like your, that was your father's name. Okay, sorry. So I thought another person there. And then I saw only, okay.
Yeah. I was confused. Why I never call my dad's name for no reason? My dad will care at me.
Yeah. Like that I saw this guy saw like Kishan and then suddenly I saw Balas. What happened? Just that Kishan or Balas or something. Okay. Oh, it was you lah. Okay, sorry. Okay, Kishan. Yeah. Okay, Haran. Okay, now we have 5 only. Wow. Termasuk saya lah. Only 3 of you. Sebab petang semua sudah keluar. Wow. Okay. So, number 6. Kita tengoklah June nanti macam mana. Jadi petang tu selalu it's raining here. Oh, Kishan tak tahu kan kenapa saya jadi petang kan? You know, already? You already know, right?
No, no.
Oh, don't know. Because usually I will like have another class at evening. And then it's a face-to-face class, physical class at my house. So, in Selangor, it's like, I also don't know lah, like other states also raining. And then here, it's like, usually in evening, raining. So, I already changed it to night. And then the night class already jadi petang. I'm just like that student, so difficult lah. To join because it's face to face, right? Need to come to my house and then it's raining, then how? So that's why I changed my timing. Yeah. Okay, now the sixth one. Okay, yang ni ada banyak lah. Kita tengok yang ni. Example 18. From a valid deductive argument. Valid maksudnya dia sudah menepati the bentuk lah. It could be form 1, could be form 2 or form 3. And for each of the following situation, all mammals are warm-blooded. Wow, no science here. All mammals are warm-blooded. Cats are mammals and cats are warm-blooded. Now you need to write down according to the premise. Nah, itu kerja awak. So, apa yang awak buat? Mereka pun sudah beri tiga ni kan? You just write first premise. This one is the second premise. This one is the conclusion. Dan awak tambah ini je boleh dapat markah. But most of the cases in exam, they didn't ask you to do that. Sebab lembaga peperiksaan menganggap itu soalan senang. Yeah, easy mark. Who wants to give to? Right. So, ini senang lah. Okay. Ha, ini pun antara soalan yang sangat famous. Mereka akan jadikan mana-mana bahagian kosong. It could be conclusion yang kosong. Or it would be like premise 2 or premise 1 yang kosong. And then you kena tentukan what is the conclusion for the sentence. Here, your bentuk 1, bentuk 2 and bentuk 3. That knowledge would help you. Okay. This type of question usually 4 marks maximum. Minimum. Sorry, minimum, not minimum. Minimum would be 2. 2 to 4. Most of the cases lah. Yeah. Emily still here. Not sleeping right. Emily. Emily, I also don't know Emily what are you doing. Okay, Kishan. Kishan said no. Okay. Premise 1, all whole numbers are real numbers. 38 is a whole number. So, what is your conclusion? Apa yang saya suka buat, saya akan tengok yang mana sama. Saya suka potong. Yang ni kan? So, kita still ada 38. Kita still ada a real number. So, apa yang kita buat, kita tulis. 38 is a real number. Dan sudah jawab. Real number means what? Oh, it's a big cerita lah for real number. Mina, I think I did notes for that day. Tak ingat sekejap. Saya kena tengok. Okay, yang ni. Hari tu saya buat nota lah. Nota sikit. Okay, you can see here. Inilah nota ringkas yang saya buat. Okay. Deductive, general to specific. Okay, right. So, you can see here. We have valid and not valid. And then sound and not sound. So, kalau valid, kita tengok form. Okay, yang ni saya tambah lah. Conclusion and kita tambah lagi. Another one is premise. Sebab selalu saya tengok premise je. Conclusion je. So, premise. So, that one is for valid. Oh, sorry. ni valid and not valid sound. Sekarang kita tengok real numbers macam just now Harun said.
Okay.
So for real numbers, we have two types of real numbers. We call rational number and irrational number. You know rational number? Boleh jadi fraction. My number, right? Can you help me send the recording to me? Because I'm sorry about this. Help me and send the recording. Which recording? Which one? This recording. It's uploaded in the YouTube. Tak perlu storage. Listen, no need storage. It's in the YouTube. Yeah. Nanti saya beri, I will give this recording to Wayne Bro and then he will upload it in the YouTube. I disconnected. Okay. Listen. If you want to screenshot also can, no problem. Deductive, inductive. Ini nanti kita belajar lah for inductive. Strong, weak, quotient and not quotient. Yang ni kita buat a separate video, separate part. Ha? Yang ni saya nak jadikan satu video. Sebab saya nak betul-betul terangkan, I don't want quantity here, I want quality education. So saya nak bagi satu je and then bagi you faham betul-betul. Because most of them yang ni dengan ini akan confuse jadi roja and then tak sedap. Okay. So sekarang kita tak nak yang jadi benda lain. Kalau kita nak bake a cake, we're going to make a cake. Sebab kadang-kadang ramai yang confuse ini dengan ini. And you need to know this one is inductive, this one is deductive. So it's different one. Ni general to specific, ni specific to general, terbalik. So now for real numbers, macam tadi Harun asked me, real numbers, we have rational number, irrational number. Rational number ialah nombor yang awak boleh dapatkan dalam fraction. Awak boleh tukar jadi pecahan. Kalau irrational number, tak boleh jadi fraction. The decimal tak boleh jadi fraction. Yang tu for irrational number. Lepas tu whole number kosong sampai apa-apa nombor lah. Yang tu semua whole numbers. And you sorry. My God. Saya tak boleh pinjam. Never mind, kita sambung. One minute, man. Sorry. Emergency tadi. Okay, now kita sambung. Okay. No lah. Not girlfriend. Don't have girlfriend. Still single. Okay, so rational number and irrational number. Kita tengok balik. Rational and irrational number. Rational number, number yang awak boleh jadikan dalam fraction. Irrational tak boleh jadi fraction. Yang kedua-dua tu kita panggil real number. Okay, so Kishan, Kishan and Haran and tadi siapa? Emily. Kalau real number, kita tengok dia rational ke tak rational. Kalau irrational number, dia boleh jadi fraction. Macam apa yang boleh jadi fraction? 0.5 boleh jadi fraction kan? 1/2. So yang ni rational. Yes, Kishan?
I said yes, Anna. 0.5.
Yeah. So like sometimes we will have like 0.0.11111 sampai tak terhingga. It's like infinity there. So kalau macam tu, kita tak boleh jadikan dalam fraction. So yang both of it, dia jadi real numbers. Okay, kan lah? Okay, sekejap. Kita masuk ni. Okay, thank you for the chat. Okay, never mind. Itu memang saya nak tunjukkan. You remind me lah to show that. So, here we have all whole number. Okay, kita sudah tulis lah kat situ. So, premise 1. If AX square, tengok kat sini. Dia tulis kuasa 2 kan? Power of 2. So maksudnya yang tu quadratic has real roots, then b square minus 4ac is greater than 0. Wow, this one kat sini semua ada dalam admit kan? Yeah. So you remember that day about the types of roots we have greater than 0, discriminant, correct? Greater than 0, equals to 0, less than 0, that thing, all lah. Discriminant or NBM is from Basel lah, yan. So, it has real roots. So, now what I'm going to do, yang ni, yang belajar at maths know lah, for the modern maths students, what you need to know, you just need to do the conclusion. No need to know about that, what's that, tak perlu. Yang kita perlu buat, kita potong apa yang sama. Yang ni dengan ini sama. Tapi you kena tengok. You need to see. They use 2 kat sini kan. So awak kena jadikan 2 juga. Macam mana? Kita tengok. 2x square plus px minus 2. A berapa? 2 kan? B is p c negative 2. Big bro is at max. So this one is A, B and C. Saya sudah tulis. Sekarang apa yang kena buat? B. B kat sini is P right. So P square minus 4. A is 2. C is negative 2. Awak tulis greater than 0. That's all. Sudah dapat markah kat situ. Kan nak? If you want, you can do. Kat sini dia bagi macam mana? Bagi dia bagi macam ni je. So no need lah. Because you need to show that you have substitute into the formula. Sebab itu saja kita buat macam tu. Boleh. Kan nak? Just showing that you substitute. That's all. So now the third one. If a straight line y equals to mx plus c parallel to the x axis, apa maksud? Kita belajar sikit lah. What's the meaning of parallel there? Apa maksud parallel? Horizontal line. Okay, apa yang sama? If two lines are parallel, what's the same thing there? Apa yang similar between the two lines? M. What is M? Gradient. Yeah, correct. Gradient. Kecerunan. Itu yang sama. That's why we call parallel. Awak pernah tengok. They use term perpendicular. I've heard about this. Haran Kishan. Perpendicular. 90 degrees. Macam ni dia jadi 90 degrees. So this one we call perpendicular, ataupun dalam PM kita panggil serenjang, berserenjang. Kalau it's like the yang like this and then this one, ni kedua-dua it's parallel. Maksudnya kat sini the M is same, the gradient is same. Yang ni dengan ini sama, that's parallel. Kadang-kadang ada yang tak tahu, that's why. So it's parallel to the x-axis. So it's horizontal. Yeah, correct lah. Tadi like Haran said, oh, this is form 3 textbook chapter 5 or 4. Yeah, it's from lower form. And then for admets also you will like you need to know about this, because you will have a chapter like they call differentiation chapter 2, admets form 5. You will learn again about this, like about dy dx, we call this lah zero or not. So nanti kita akan belajar for form 5. So kita kena tahu. Yes, Kitchen.
Must remember the all the lines and all that. Nah.
Which line?
The total the 90 degrees, straight line, parallel, all the cross multifunction and all.
Like the this one. Are you talking about this? The acute angle, obtuse angle, that one.
Oh yeah, those things.
Yes, you need to know about that.
Okay.
It's compulsory to know. Okay. Why I say compulsory to know? Because sometimes they will ask you for paper 1. Or sometimes dalam soalan yang panjang lebar, mereka like when you get 2 answers, sometimes you will do a quadratic equation and the quadratic equation awak boleh dapat the angles, awak boleh dapat angle dalam bilang apa darjah. Okay, and so you will get that. So kalau contoh mereka bagi x1 is 60, another one is 120. Lepas tu dalam jawapan mereka kata x is a acute angle, so which one do you choose, 60 or 120? 60 or 160 lah. So you write x is 60. So untuk ini awak akan dapat markah tau. Even though you dapat for this one, you will get for the acute angle also. So you need to know acute angle, obtuse angle, right angle, that kind of angles. So you need to know about that, all the reflex angles also. So okay, so kena tahu tentang itu semualah. Okay, that's why, that's the reason. Okay, kat sini dia kata parallel to the x axis, then m equals to 0. M, they said m is not 0. So apa yang ni lah, apa yang awak kena tulis? Yang ni, mereka tulis yang ni. This one sama dengan itu, tapi mereka negate that. So what do you write? Straight line y equals to mx plus c is not parallel to x axis. Habis. Macam ni lah dia tulis. Can understand? Not parallel. Kalau M tidak sama dengan kosong, maksudnya tak parallel lah. Okay, kan lah. Haran and Kishan yang actively message here, kan? And Emily, kan? Okay. Kan lah. This one also. 37 is a prime number. 37 has only 2 factors. So apa yang premise 1? Apa? Macam mana you tulis? Saya nak jawapan from you. All. Because this one is C, is A, C is B, right? So, all A is B. Macam tu kita tulis. All A are B, ha? So, macam mana kita tulis? All. All. All primer number has only two factors. Yeah, correct. Not n lakh, I took it. So all prime numbers has two only word I'm talking. Has why I use has here. So have only two factors. Add info equals to one and itself additional. All prime numbers are two factors. Not like that. I couldn't understand what they're talking at. Info equals to one and itself. I mean additional knowledge one and the number itself. Oh. Okay, yeah. So just now, Kishan. Okay. Yeah. Oh, yeah, yeah. Now I can understand. Yeah. Correct. Okay, so all prime numbers, kita start daripada all. If you boleh masukkan A, you can and you can insert it. If cannot, never mind. All prime numbers have only two factors. Kalau lah, macam tadi saya tersalah tulis, tapi it should be have according to your grammar English. Tapi kalau you tulis has, tiada masalah. Still correct. Why still correct? Sebab ini it's at not admins. This one is max. So tiada masalah lah. Kalau English baru masalah because this is plural thing here. Prime numbers, not number. Okay. So kita ikut tu. If the annual sales of A and C company exceeds 3 million, then the employees get a bonus of 3 months salary. Premise 2 tak tahu. Premise 3 dia kata the annual sales of A and C company do not exceed 3 million. So mereka negate. So apa yang sama, ini yang sama. Tapi mereka negatifkan, negatifkan. So ini pun you kena negatif. You write lah, the employees do not get a bonus of 3 months salary. Dah habis. Awak tulis macam tu, you will get your marks. Boleh faham kan? Kan jangan tidur, jangan mengantuk. Stay fresh. Okay. So yang tu samalah untuk the C also. Same also. No, I mean like different things. X tidak sama dengan 9. Awak tengok, okay. So mereka tulis ini sahaja. So apa yang awak kena buat, awak tulislah 9 is not the root of that one. Habis. Sebab mereka guna if then. Yang ni satu statement. This one another one. So kat situ awak tulislah K. What is K? Mereka bagi 9. So 9 is not a root of 3x square minus 5 equals to 12. Okay. So sampai sini, can you understand? Can ah? Okay, Christian said yes. Harun? Can. Okay. Emily? If I have any question, I'll ask. headphone. I just went to her. Oh, with headphone. She's. I eating dinner. Oh, okay. So hopefully you guys can understand. Okay, so hopefully you guys understand. Okay, guys. Yeah. Okay, here. This video going to upload in YouTube. Sekarang yang message sama saya sedang tunjuk dalam YouTube also. Okay. Never mind, they also don't know your real name, your face also, right? So no, not any problem. Okay. So hopefully like you can understand this thing. Okay. So additional mathematics still it's from 8 to 9:30. Macam biasa. Tiada pertukaran masa. Only for modern maths yang saya tukar. Okay, kan? So tiada masalah for admat lah. Admat still same macam usual would be at night. Oh my god, Ichi. Masalah is one. Okay,